court to seek a review of the public protector's report, which it's described as irrational and unreasonable. The lender is adamant that it met its obligations to the Reserve Bank in 1995. The bank claims that the report contains numerous misrepresentations and factual inaccuracies that form the basis of the public protector's findings. Absa said that the misconceptions and inaccuracies in the report are profound and damaging to Absa's reputation. The bank denies receiving 1.125 billion rand by way of unlawful assistance, adding that Absa's obligations to the South African Reserve Bank were met in full by October 1995. The bank also argues that the public protector's order that Parliament amend the constitutional role of the Reserve Bank is beyond her powers and is a serious threat to the country's economy. Earlier we spoke to Absa spokesperson Songezo Zibi, and this is what he had to say.
Fundamentally, we do not believe the public protector is empowered to change the constitution.
Yeah.
Because all constitutional bodies and instruments, including the constitutional court, cannot invent new sections of the constitution. They interpret the constitution. And we believe the public protector erred in that respect. There is also another issue relating to prescription, by the way, and that is a period over which a debt lapses, which she has also, on a whim, amended completely with no legal basis at all. So there are lots of grounds for a review of this decision.